Okay, Kasa, I will explain to you the second step here. So after you have do this one, okay, after you have logged into the computer, okay, then know that all students, okay, every student use the same user ID for this login. Okay, so now I will show you this one. Basically, you need to go to computer L drive, then you double click the setup file. Okay. So what I do is I go to computer. Okay, so to go to computer, you need to go to the desktop here. Okay, this is a classroom. Yeah, I'm doing a demo in the classroom. It's not in the computer lab environment. So it's not exactly the same, but essentially it's like that. Okay, so you go to computer, then you go to L drive, and you look for the setup file. Right. So you double click the setup file. Okay, don't talk. Your invigilator will issue a password slip to you. It's a it's a piece of paper, password slip. So you enter your ID. Every student will have a different ID. Okay, then you key in the password. Okay, then you click connect. Okay, so you have to wait a while in the computer lab, it may take longer time because there are many students logging at the same time. Okay, then you will see connect succeeded to Z drive. Right, you click OK. So next, what we do? Okay, we have picked the connect, and you will see a Z drive. So now I do this step. Go to computer, Z drive. Take note, it's not L drive. A lot of students go to L drive, it's wrong. Go to Z drive, and you go to this PT1 test file folder and so on. Okay, so now I'll show you this one. So how to go to computer Z drive? Double click computer, then go to Z drive. Correct, go to Z drive. Then go to the PT1 test folder. Right, so you see this solution file. Right, so you double click. Okay, and sometimes you will see something like that. And how do you display the form? Okay, if you see like that, you should know how to open the form. Please don't ask me during the practical test. You should know. Okay, if you don't know, I can do it for you. Then I minus mark. Okay, so you go to the Solution Explorer, double click, you will see a blank form, right? You see a blank form, so you follow the instruction to do the practical test. Okay, another thing is, do you see this carefully? When you key in your user ID and password, please key in carefully. Let's say it's wrong, your computer will take a long time to verify and so on, and then this will delay. Same thing for this one, key in your ID and password carefully. If it's wrong, it will take a long time to redo again. Okay, so just now I show you already, after you open the VB solution file, okay, think about this one. Because in the computer lab, this is the first time you launch a program. It will open the VB program, it might take a few minutes. Okay, that's why I ask you all to go into the computer lab punctually. If you are late, then you will start everything late. Okay, so I actually reserve 10 minutes for you all to do all this thing. Okay, then there are some instructions here which I cannot simulate. Right? So if you are prompted to sign in, right, then you click the link, not now, maybe later. This one I can't simulate. And then also, when you launch the software, the Visual Basic software might prompt you to select the development setting. Right, so when you see this, you have to select general development setting. Then you click the button Start Visual Studio. Okay, and then also another one very important thing is remember to click this, it's written here, click this save all icon frequently to save your work. Why? In case your computer hangs, if you didn't save your work, you lose your work and then you have to redo again. Okay?